Hey everybody, welcome to Human Landmine Season 2, Episode 7. We were gone for a couple weeks. I was filming a short film with friend of the show, Grayson Powell. But now we're back to getting hammered.
Yeah, it was Pride Week in Charleston, and I had a two-week hangover. We already made this joke, but Steven's audio fucked up. So I had to remake the joke.
It comes off less natural.
It doesn't feel
now.
Natural, just like when a robot rapes you, doesn't feel natural.
Nothing could feel less natural than that, I would think. Unless you
except lambskin condom.
What kind of condom?
It's like fucking two animals at once.
Yeah, and maybe being like covered in chemicals.
We have the boys from Merman Supply Company here.
Say hi, guys.
What's up?
This is Nigel and Griff. They're gonna be with us all day.
We have a clothing company in Charleston. We're about to
get rid of us.
You know, we're not getting rid of them.
You're fucking stuck.
I'm plugged in.
Hey.
They're like herpes, gentlemen, and chicks with dicks.
Yeah, hey, we're gonna kick off the herpes episode in just a few short moments. Stick around. Cut.
Oh, wait.
All right, I didn't cut.
Don't cut your audio.
I didn't.
Did you cut it?
No.
This is the herpes episode?
Well, that's news to me.
No, no. Both of y'all know you had herpes.
Everyone's got HPV.
No, I wanted to say that from here on out, every episode of Human Landmines is going to be sponsored by Merman Supply Company. Merman Supply Company. Get wet. This is the Merman episode of Human Landmines.
Stay tuned, bitches.
Stay tuned, bitches. Don't leave, bitches.
You are listening to 60 people in America's favorite daytime talk show. Still chugging, still talking shit, still about to explode on season 2 of Human Landmines.
Hey everybody, welcome to Season 2, Episode 7 of Human Landmines. This is the Merman episode.
Herpman.
We have Nigel and Griff in the studio.
And they have graciously provided us with apparel, as you can see once again. From their little store. I didn't mean for that to be demeaning.
Steven, don't bullshit us. You better walk around New York with that.
Dude, I'll fucking wear this every day.
I don't want to see you change it.
Do you guys just sell shit online or do you sell shit in person?
There's some chicks that are super hippie commune chicks, and they don't shower for like 2 weeks, and they still get fucked. So if you change your clothes, you're a dickhead.
And you're not going to get fucked for 3 weeks.
No, it's cool. I like a gray shirt because it shows sweat also.
Yeah.
I want people to know how long I've been wearing it.
You've been running from sharks all day.
Super sweaty.
All fucking day, baby.
Is it weird that we're doing the Merman episode during Shark Week? Is that ironic?
No, we have some corporate sponsored partnerships with them.
Let's
you
ask
gotta call Discovery.
Let's ask the dudes where the idea for Merman came up.
Yeah.
Hey, by the way,
nobody's ever
stutter,
asked us this question.
Yeah, we don't have
to answer
this. We want to be mermaids, but we have penises.
Well, you guys don't know.
And it didn't fit in our fish.
What the show's going to hold. But just know, this little earbud.
We're like mermaids, but with penises.
Everything you say happens again a second later. So if I sound slow or like a retard.
You always sound slow.
I know.
I know.
All right. So, what brought up the idea for Merman?
Nadja, do you have an answer for this?
I just said it.
Yeah,
you wanted to be a mermaid, but you have a penis.
We have dicks.
Yeah, we're like mermaids with penises.
Is that you the actual like name of male mermaids? Merman?
Merman.
That's what they're called in mythology?
Well, the company was actually called Merman, but people started
but people just called
pronouncing
it, Merman,
it wrong.
Like,
so
we're like, all
right,
well,
we went with it. So we're like, we're,
nice.
we thought Merman was a cool name.
So we put a shark
like
on
an old uncle's name that we were like, fuck it, let's roll with his name. It was weird enough.
You guys sell anything besides shirts?
Yeah, we sell
tracker hats, board shorts.
If I type
covers,
it into Google, can I find it?
Pieces.
Yeah, you can go to mermansupply.com right now. Search around on the site.
Yeah,
that's what I'm about to do.
Pull it. Yeah, that'll be easier than us talking about it.
Yeah, we don't want to talk about our.
We
company.
Can see the
oh,
reflection
yeah.
in Steven's glasses, which is like looking in a mirror and seeing a joke of our own lives.
Had either of you guys done anything in fashion before this?
No, I kind of just jumped on the train like a hobo and fucking figured it out.
That's awesome.
Griff went to school for graphic design, and Nigel went to school hard knocks.
I took night classes at the school for hard knocks, and
fucking worked out.
Got my PhD in fuckery, so.
Hell yeah.
Well,
here we
damn,
are.
We got Doctor and Ordain.
We're on the big time.
Let no, me, I think it's cool as shit, though, that...
Proud of you by Mango.
Hey, but to be real with you guys, you guys started your own clothing company, which is wildly popular in Charleston.
Yep.
And you're still treating it like nothing happened with it. Like, yeah, it's cool as shit.
I enjoy doing it. So, like, it's an outlet for me because as a graphic designer, like, I'm paid to do work. And then Merman is like, I can do whatever I want. Like, I can just be artistic and do shit. And it's for what me and Nigel enjoy. So it's more of like an outlet for me of like a hobby, just like having this talk show or like Paul's writing and his music, your music.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a fun outlet and we enjoy it.
Was it, were there stumbling blocks or did you guys pretty much kick it off and it took off right away?
Oh, dude, we fucking stumble all day, every day.
Yeah,
we're not
yeah.
even rolling smooth, but it's fun. That's the whole thing. People come up to me all the time. They're like, oh, bro, I got this fucking sweet idea for a t-shirt. I want you to put like a dick on a t-shirt and say, dick.
I was going to say, as much as we've stumbled, it's been a forward stumble.
Yeah.
So.
That's sick.
It's like a drunk person that
I
like,
think,
is about
like
to fall forward into the street
still
and
falls make
it backwards.
Home, but they
like,
still
there's
they still
a lot there. Of there's a lot of stories that have this underlying philosophy to them. Like, I'll cite Walker Percy's, the moviegoer. He's like, this guy just watches movies all the time and he doesn't like to interact with other humans, but there's a few humans he really loves. But he also appreciates interacting with a bunch of random humans. And he writes about the search. And every character in a movie, like, searches. They
yeah.
search for that purpose of life. And there's no character in a movie that doesn't search for that like, wonderful life.
Right.
And so the whole movie is about, like, if people have the search or not. Or that whole book. And
yeah.
Merman's underlying, like, philosophy is if you're going to take a tumble... Tumble forward.
That's beautiful.
That's so deep.
You
that's
got
so beautiful.
Fucking sentimental real deep with that.
Yeah.
But you had a point.
I'll be there for you when the rain starts.
Steven,
to
answer
fall.
The question though. Like we have a goal. We definitely have a goal, but we're doing one step at a time and we're having fun with it. And I think that's the beauty of it. Like people sometimes take business like super seriously and we do too, but we're just having fun with it.
Yeah, there's no point in doing it if it's not fun. Then it's not really, I wouldn't think it would be worth it.
Nigel and I talk about this all the time. Like, if it blows up, we're just going to fucking keep partying harder. We're just going to buy
it, has it become a good source of income for you guys yet? Or is it not there yet?
Next question, please, Steven.
Yeah, next question. Please, we'll move to the next one.
Is that inappropriate to ask?
No,
it's
not.
No, it's very appropriate to ask. Just move that, the fucking
up. Hey, can we speed up this interview? I got to get to my restaurant job.
But, dude.
So, Roddy, but Mangarita.
Merman also made the Beach Metal Godwin Falcon shirts.
Oh, sick.
Yeah, they can do heat transfer.
Yeah, so we like do screen printing too for other shit, but that's nice. Like Merman's just the fun project. We're in the works right now where maybe we'll answer that question to the public.
you don't have a physical place where you sell stuff, right? It's all online.
It's all intangible right now.
Cool. Moving and shaking.
2 weeks we're gonna be in a store on King Street, though. So.
Yeah, so y'all look out for
like
that.
You're gonna have your product in a store or have a Merman store?
We're gonna have a
little kind
store
of
front.
Both.
Kind of both, yeah.
Oh, that's fucking awesome, man.
Yeah.
Good for you guys.
We're excited. We're like I said, one step at a time.
Awesome, man.
That's the beauty of it.
You can get drunk, eat a sandwich, and buy our stuff.
And you might
wow.
Yeah.
You might learn something.
You might learn something. Wow. Or get a pair of headphones. Wow.
That's an experience.
Holy shit.
Hey,
blow your
Steven,
fucking mind.
I think we already sucked the Merman guy's dicks.
Ooh.
So.
Let's talk shit about something else.
Let's start.
Yeah, enough about us.
Yeah, how about
how
you,
are
Steven?
You?
Well, what I wanted to talk about today that has nothing to do with Merman. Is good. These fucking people on Facebook that one, dump a bucket of ice on their head, or two, dump. Set themselves on fire.
Okay.
Go do something fucking cool, you idiots.
Yeah, start a clothing company, dicks.
If you want to impress me, dump a bucket of ice on yourself and then let yourself on fire. Then I'll be fucking impressed.
That'd be impressive, well, right?
So the ice
challenge in that. It seems
the ice the ice bucket challenge.
You have 24 hours.
It's for a good cause. It's for a good
get drunk.
It's for a good cause. It's if you don't do it, you gotta donate $100 to ALS.
I got a challenge.
I got a challenge.
Let's make a challenge right now.
If you don't do it, you have to donate money to Human Limelines and Merman.
Oh, boom.
Let's make some fucked up challenge right now.
Business, man.
Yeah, I challenge you to watch the podcast or the show and buy a shirt. That's a fucking challenge.
That's a fucking challenge.
That's a great challenge.
Or we could just cut off our dicks to save herpes. This is the herpes episode, right?
No, only
I challenge you to cut off your dick
balls
to stop
herpes.
Wait, would that... Herpes could probably still live down there.
Well, I mean, but you'd have to touch it like a...
You'd have to touch your
like
severed
standalone
ball sack with your dick.
You'd probably be like...
You'd have to poke your severed dick with your ball sack.
Ooh. Oh, you're only taking the shot. You're leaving the bag?
Yeah, you're leaving the bag? No. You're not a coin person?
I'm sorry. I'd cut off my balls before I cut off my dick.
Take my dick, but don't take my balls. Wait.
What, you gonna team
would you rather? Would you
can you
rather?
Imagine if you cut off your dick and your balls and you still had herpes?
Dude, would you just be like, oh, that didn't work? Like, shit. Okay. Would you rather have balls and no dick and be able to finish, or a dick and no balls? Like it's just like a little belly button that spit, or like would you rather? Yeah, think about it. Like, that's a tough challenge. That's like, people are like,
no,
would you
everybody
rather,
would rather
like,
have a dick.
I would rather
everybody
have a dick.
A dick.
So you're all performance. There's no, like... Yeah.
I don't want to, like, drunkenly ball dunk everybody.
But...
Nobody
would
like
balls. It'd be like those old Reebok pump shoes. And you just, like, mush it a couple of times. With a ball sack under it.
Well, this escalated quickly.
You gotta stop the whole show, so here we are.
You asked for the whole show. You actually did.
If you enter into a sexual interaction, you're talking to a girl at a bar, you guys are hitting it off, and shit's going well, you invite her back to your place. Like, she might still be down if you don't have balls, but if you don't have a dick,
well,
it's a real problem.
As a grown man, sometimes mine disappear in the heat of the moment anyway, so...
This is just like the foot job chicks. Some girls love giving foot jobs, or some guys love getting them. Some some way, somehow, someone videos someone getting a foot job from someone.
I'm a middle class American. I love all and jobs.
I don't want to get my jobs. Dick and balls kicked in for
there's a job out there for everyone.
But
if you get bored, somebody you can come make some t-shirts.
Wants to. I heard a
and
sad
if somebody that wants to, and somebody needs to, and somebody's gonna do it.
Yeah, but somebody's gonna do a lot of different kind of jobs. But I'm telling you that nobody is gonna chop their dick off instead of their balls. In this hypothetical.
There might be the guy who gets paid to teabag people.
Is it funny to put your balls in someone's face or your dong?
Well,
I don't think.
Is it
I'm undecided.
I don't want to find out right now.
How did we get here?
It doesn't matter.
But you got to think, like, Steven and I know a guy on Facebook who is terrifyingly sociopathical and probably
That's a
serial
way
killer.
To do something too.
And
yeah. Oh, yeah, he might do it.
Find his dick as such a burden psychologically and would rather lose his dick than his nuts.
That's a great
wasn't
point.
There that rapper recently that
you're right.
Cut off his dick and jumped off the porch. Yeah.
Well, he chopped off his dick head.
That was in your neck of the woods.
Chopped
you,
off his
doing
balls.
Some weird shit up there.
And
I
then
know
chopped
country,
off the
Jesus
rest
Christ.
Of his shaft.
And he said it was basically because he realized his dick was the root of all evil or something like that.
Yeah. It's funny you mention this because we talked about on the last episode, he had his dick surgically put back together and wants to make a porn to prove that it still works.
It's like Screech from
it.
Saved by the Bell.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to see
he
it.
He said, does Jay-Z know how to strong arm a hoe? Does Kanye know how to rant? Can Chris Brown dance? Of course it works. I want to make... And Vivid Video is like giving him offers for his chopped up, mangled Frankenstein cock.
I got to give him the most street cred. That's like the most hard-ass shit you can do is like cut your dick off and then sew it back on. Like a
Yeah, I mean, you get your G card. Like
that's a challenge
right there.
Right there.
That's a challenge. You got 24 hours, fuckers. Go.
He's like, you want to be impressed? I cut my dick off, set it back on, and made a porn. And you guys can't even make a porn.
And if you don't do it, you have to donate to a herpes charity.
Yeah, and if you can't watch the porn in its entirety, you've got to donate a sandwich to Meals on Wheels. You got to donate a hot dog.
Cost
All right, well, yeah. I got to say this. So, dumping an ice bucket on yourself.
Okay, this is where it started.
Or paying $100 to ALS. You should just pay $100. Suck it up, make some money, and pay the money to the organization instead of being a fucking loser with a camera phone.
So what you're saying is all these people that are posting these videos of them doing it are actually just too cheap to donate money?
Yes.
And if you don't do it within 24 hours, you got to dump $100.
I'm a fan for the fire challenge because
here's the deal: whoever wants to donate dumping a bucket of ice water, like meet me on the streets on a hot rickshaw day. I'll let you dump a fucking bucket of ice water on me all fucking day long. Donate whatever you want.
Here's the root of the problem. The root of the problem is some people, like, you know, they went to work that day. Somebody told them to dump a bucket of ice water on their head. They came home. They told their significant other. They were like, we're going to do this really exciting thing. You're going to dump a bucket of ice water on my head. And that was the most fucking exciting thing they did all week. And they put on social media and they're like, oh, look how fun I am. Even though a million other people did this, this is how I express myself. It's
that
just
was
sad.
That's $100 million they didn't donate.
Exactly.
Yeah. This, so
like, do something cool. Steven, like go out on the boat and run up the train trestle and jump off the train trestle and then dare your friends to do that.
Give a shrine
like,
or
do something
dollar.
Fucking cool.
Just are you able to pull up the fire challenge? And there's like, no consequences for the fire challenge. People just dumping nail polish remover all over themselves and lighting their bodies on fire.
In a shower.
Well, they do it in the shower or by a pool.
Or so near a pool, yeah.
They don't, so they can get underwater.
No, do that shit on King and Calhoun and run as fast as you can.
Griff Dog's a bro.
I thought we were
do a fire challenge when there's no water around. Like an adult.
Yeah. Girl, stop, drop, and roll like they taught you in elementary school.
Yeah. Can you pull up a fire challenge video just to kind of...
I'm trying to. It's I'm looking at an ad right now, but it's going to be over in 2 seconds.
Okay, good.
My favorite videos are like the stupid viral ones, but they're awesome in their own. Like the fire.
Like what? What do you...
Like, yo, six of these people in my cover photo have been on human landmines besides me.
All right, guys, the fire challenge is playing.
All right, so there's just a bunch of people fucking dumping nail polish remover on their bare bodies and lighting themselves on fire.
I can think of so many better challenges.
Well, we got a human landmines challenge.
What were we talking about, McCall?
Yes, we do.
What is that shit called? The kids these days.
The kids these days.
Oh, Jankum. Do the Jankum challenge.
What is Jankum? Challenge.
Oh, dude, the Jankum.
So, right now, this chick's introducing the fire challenge.
I thought that was a chick, but that's just a dude with big pecs. Okay.
Hey, Anna Kasparian.
Oh, he's on fire. That was stupid. That was an
Why are people
enough.
Doing that? And why would you do that with
this guy? Like, burns, doesn't fucking... he? Look at him. He's dumb. He jumped out of the bathtub. You're supposed to jump in the bathtub. He jumped out
of the towards
the
water.
You failed the dumbest challenge in your life.
Like, here's the thing. If I set myself on fire, I'd want to be the only person setting myself on fire. The fact that other people were doing it would actually discourage me from doing it. You know? I would be so pissed off to find out everybody was setting
themselves on fire. This is against evolutionary biology. Yes,
this is so stupid.
Yes, I'm not racist, but this seems kind of like a cheap tactic. Right now.
No.
Is this... Alright. Fire challenge. Pointless. It's
pointless. Let's get over that. That shit's stupid. Well,
so, Paul and I would like to issue a challenge to all of the Human Landmines listeners. It is as follows. Go, Paul.
Alright, so the Human Landmines liquid nitrogen challenge is you dunk both your hands 4 inches past the wrist into liquid nitrogen. And after they freeze solid, you smash your hands up. So you can't use the internet anymore.
Oh, okay.
And so
you're done.
You're fucking done with the internet. You're not going to bleed out. Human Landmines Liquid Nitrogen Challenge. It will pay you $100. If you videotape
well,
you smashing
hey,
your hands.
Donate $100 to the Ice Bucket Challenge.
Yeah.
We're going to donate $100 to the people making cool, like, hook arms.
$100 cash.
Here's the deal. If you don't...
If you just bash your hands off so you can't use the fucking internet anymore.
If only one of your hands falls off, you get nothing.
So...
You get $50.
Steven...
to buy a glove for the other one.
We've all been talking about tragedies that have happened to us, and we don't want to know about them through Facebook.
Yeah, everybody calm the fuck down when celebrities die. That's another one. Yeah,
except for the Tony Stewart thing. Like, that was cool watching.
Tony Stewart hit a fucking other race car driver in the middle of the track that he had a vengeance against.
Really? Like
and murdered him. With his
really?
Car.
You don't know about this?
Yeah.
No. Describe this.
Google that one. Just Google Tony Stewart. Apparently, during a race the other night, he spun on another driver, and the driver got out of his car on the track to confront him, and Tony Stewart just ran over him.
It killed him?
Yeah, it killed him.
What?
And they're still like taking an investigation and stuff, trying to figure out if it was on purpose or not. But I mean,
holy shit.
Kind of, you know.
And like.
If you're on a race track,
I actually
you
wanted
don't...
to get on this topic because people hate on NASCAR. And so, like, the people that aren't NASCAR fans are going to watch
Which
this.
Which is everyone or, except what, Southerners.
Is it, yeah, Southern... except fucking rednecks, but product of what?
I like
I came from. So. It's going to have bad publicity towards NASCAR, but at the same time...
Of course.
But it wasn't a NASCAR race.
It doesn't matter.
Well, there's some golfers that want to kill each other. But if you whack some dude in the head with a 9-iron, you know, it's unjustified.
It's unjustified to run over someone, too.
Yeah, it's like, hey, you got in the way of my, like, crazy rogue 9-iron swing and I killed him.
Yeah, that doesn't happen as much.
It's under investigation, but we think it was an accident.
Holy shit. People are just running people over on TV now.
But
huh?
But at the same time, like, you don't run out in the middle of a race. I mean, you don't run out in the middle of the street. I mean, a bunch of fucking idiots do it on Friday night in downtown King Street all the time. I'm surprised they don't get fucking... We're going to start calling it Tony Stewart.
Yeah, you just got toned.
You just got toned.
It's literally just like spill out in the street. Whatever happened to like looking both ways? Like, natural instinct should tell you like caution, look both ways. But this guy ran out on the track. Like, he was looking for death.
Jesus.
Or.
So,
or Tony, but either way, he found him.
What's his name?
I must call that dude a Ben Franklin. Give me liberty or give me death.
Take he my balls, death. But don't take my shaft.
Yeah.
Take Wait, my who balls, did he kill, though? Don't who take my shaft. Kill? Still
so it was like a dirt track race.
Yeah, it was like some 20-year-old dude, a little young guy driver. But
Kevin Ward.
Yeah,
Kevin
there you go. Ward.
Robin Williams, yeah, comedy genius, recently passed.
Which is sad. We all agree on that.
I'm so sad.
He fucking made us laugh for a long
but
time.
But what people don't understand is that Robin Williams can't read Facebook from heaven.
Yes.
Thank you. That was the fucking
we just connected from our two studios, Tokyo and London.
Yeah, Tokyo and
Robin
London.
Robin Williams
agreed.
Cannot read Facebook in heaven.
Yeah.
So
that's a nice summation, actually.
I feel like Facebook's just become a place to air out your dirty laundry and to
don't do it.
And to like
smartest
talk to
so,
people in the past. And,
so you guys have Facebook because you can promote Merman on there and it's great.
I just want to know what you're eating for lunch and where you're at with your mom.
Yeah. Right?
My phone's down, but I promise my BLT has lettuce and tomato on it.
I want to know how
I
want to
see.
Fucking,
yeah, nom nom nom. I want to see your bowl of lunch with a nom nom nom.
I
want to
see how many pictures of like the battery and the bridge you can take in different colorations every day.
Oh, that must be a nightmare, man. Living in Charleston and seeing people.
If it rains in Charleston, I think a flood is the only thing people fucking talk about. It's like, dude, we've lived in Charleston forever. It's gonna flood. This is not fucking news.
Charleston.
We got floods,
yoga,
Everyone's
and sandwiches.
Like, flood day.
Let's Facebook that.
Let's shoot handstands
like
on top
yoga
of flood
picks.
Water.
I want to fucking know what you're eating.
Let's do handstands on top of flood water with our French toast brunch picture.
I just love living in Charleston because every time I look at my Instagram, it's all these girls doing yoga poses, and I'm like, oh, I haven't jacked off today, and I could just go, no ham.
I mean, that's
on my John Ham.
I mean, yoga does that for you. Like,
I mean, that shit's all about, like, how cool am I? Let me let you know. Let me show you how cool I am.
That's what I do. It's what I do. I'm going to do it and take photos of it every day.
To be honest with you, I still don't have a personal Instagram. I only have a Merman Instagram.
I have a personal Instagram, but I usually like post big selfies of like big party crews, and we all like pose like we're a Saved by the Bell cast.
I've been a part of the selfie. It's like actually epic. And it usually only happens between like 2 and 7, which is a broad area. And sometimes it happens multiple times between.
And there's usually broads in the area. Steven, would this make Human Landmines history if all three of us mangina the camera?
Yeah, but what I would do is not show it on screen.
Oh.
Yeah,
I have control.
Yeah, I'll turn around. So it's just the fruit cocktail.
I have control.
Like, people. Come on. What do you got?
Man, what you got,
what
Steve?
You guys
what
do
you got for us?
We're hustling, you know. Next
well,
question.
I was just going to tell you guys
I think that,
what I just.
Well, we were talking about how the way people deal with grief, especially having social media as a platform, is bad.
Yeah.
Why don't you tell us about your part?
No, I was just going to say, I would tell you guys what I told our other buddies, the Zachs, which is like, you guys got to defriend people and ignore people. Social media is cool if you only follow cool shit. It's your fault like that there's terrible things on there. You got to
quit your own
You got to bring some shit off. You got to cut some people off.
You should have like 28 friends on there.
Like, I mean, I don't even have 28 friends. It makes zero sense. Like, Like, they need to get a button next to the like button. It's like unfriend. Like, there should only be two options. Like, like.
Unfriend.
Or unfriend.
Because you don't
I never want to see
you
again.
You don't want to be their friend. Like,
that's, that yeah, that's awesome.
I can streamline my process.
Take that, Zuckerberg.
I like that.
We're just going to... So, we're actually in the process of just developing new apps.
Yeah, you got to hear about...
Oh, yeah, tell me you guys' app ideas.
Oh, man, how many app ideas do we have, dude?
Insta-rip.
Insta-rip. So, Insta-rip, you guys can take this. I just want to see this shit fucking happen.
What happens?
You can screenshot your photo.
Okay.
Of anything. And we'll send you a rip.
And
to
then
post
it posts
on your friends.
So we rip, just like Snapchat, and it comes across the picture. And that's what posts, is how fucked up
if
your friend
is. If somebody takes a photo of them eating a cheeseburger, we're like, nice cheeseburger, fatty. Have an enjoyable cholesterol overload until you're dead, bitch.
I like that idea.
I'm really
Insta-rip.
Into this.
I really like that.
So, then we have the point of, like, you're posting dumb shit, we're going to call you out on your fucking dumb shit. Oh, you can put your legs up in the air in this certain kind of way? Cool, we're going to fucking rip the shit out of you for it.
We also got Insta-tits.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what's that?
It's the tits, vagina.
Tits and clits, dude.
Penis. It's like Instagram,
but only...
it's only erogenous zones.
Oh, like has to
it's
be zoomed
all
in.
All nude pics.
Oh, okay. It's not like just a tit. It can be a whole nude person.
Yeah, or like if I want to take a dick pic and post it on Insta Tits, I could totally do so.
Cool. That's a good one too. What else you got?
Oh, dude, let's keep it rolling.
Insta bro.
You just can. It talks to you.
Yeah,
friends. It's like Siri, but with the penis.
That's actually false.
It's like, got it's like some swagger to it, too.
Inspired
it calls you
mermaid.
So you're like,
Instabro,
you're like, you
Siri
it to like search something on the internet, and it's like, what the fuck are you looking for that for? You
hey,
forget.
Should we play
you're
a game?
Like, should I bang this chick? And it's like, yeah, but wrap it up, bro.
No, Instabro is the app that's like, only lets bro photos be published.
We should play a game like what kind of questions we can ask Siri. The worst questions ever.
Dude.
No, seriously.
She doesn't even listen to set my alarm for noon. I don't want to ask her dumb questions. All the answers will be the same. I don't understand your question.
This
Siri,
is why we need Insta bro
for noon.
Insta bro. If you have a question, if you're like in
your
doubt, like, what should
like
I do in this situation? Instabro will tell you
hey,
what the fuck to do.
The Instabro voice's name is Chad.
Yes. It should be. Oh, what about Instashits?
Instashits.
But like,
have we researched this? I feel like that might already be out.
No, it's not already out, but that's what fucking happens. I feel like
if we can get everybody to take pictures of poop.
I can tell what my friends have eaten for the past week, because all they do is Snapchat their fucking poop to me.
But what if, you know how like Facebook has facial recognition software?
Yeah.
If we get enough poops, like that we can have
identify
big data on
people.
Poop, we
no,
can
like,
find
Paul
out like if people
today.
Are really ill, like if everybody always takes pictures
Paul
of their poop, and, like, a thing will go off like, whoa, that's 5 days in a row of red.
You should go to the hospital.
You've been it's Pride Week.
It's Pride Week. Oh, you blew it out.
5 days of red. It must be Pride Week again.
5 days of red. I only have my period once a year, and it's Pride Week.
And it lasts 2 weeks.
It's a 2 week butthole hangover.
This is the herpes episode.
Good.
Prolapse.
Good. I'm glad we got there.
Yeah,
how do we keep ending up on
how do we, yeah, like, Steven, hit us with another one.
So, Paul and I found this thing. It's been on the internet for a while, but Paul and I kind of refound it. It's how much Hunter S. Thompson, how many drugs he would do every day.
Dude, I live
and
my
it's
life.
Pretty mind-blowing.
Like Vin Diesel, 1/4 mile at a time, but it's to be like fucking Hunter S. Thompson.
All right, I'm going to briefly go over
give me his to-do list. I want to hear the checklist.
Yeah, dude. His bucket list must be awesome.
Here we go. He wakes up at 3 p.m. 3:05, Chivas Regal with the morning papers and cigarettes. 345, cocaine. 350, more whiskey, more cigarettes. 405, more coffee, more cigarettes. 415, cocaine. 416, cigarettes. 430, 454, and 505, cocaine.
Nice.
511, coffee. Where's he getting the hard
drugs?
Why do you need coffee with that much cocaine?
No, listen to this list.
545, cocaine. 6 o'clock, weed to take edge off the day. Then, the one of the coolest parts, 7:05 p.m., it's lunch. His lunch is Heineken, two margaritas, coleslaw, taco salad, double order onion rings, carrot cake, ice cream, bean fritter, cigarettes, Heineken, cocaine, and for the ride home, a snow cone, which is just shredded ice with 3 or 4 shots of whiskey. 9 p.m., starts snorting cocaine seriously. 10 p.m., drops acid. 11 p.m.,
there we go.
Chartreuse, cocaine, and grass. What is chartreuse?
It's a liqueur.
Yeah.
Thank you. 11:30, cocaine. Midnight, Hunter S. Thompson is ready to write. From midnight to 6 a.m., he writes, and here's what he has. Chartreuse, cocaine, weed, whiskey, coffee, Heineken, cloves, a grapefruit, more cigarettes, orange juice, gin, and he keeps porn on constantly for 6 hours.
Porn?
6 p.m., yeah. Nice. 6 p.m., which seems like awesome. He gets in a hot tub, has champagne, Dove bars, and fettuccine Alfredo. 8 p.m. He takes something called a halcyon, which I
see. Is he sleeping in my grandma's house?
Yeah,
he has fettuccine Alfredo at 7 a.m. That sounds like my recently passed grandmother's house.
But yeah, he's a monster. He's a monster.
It's Labor Day and Myrtle.
Monster's an understatement. That was probably
it's Labor
the most...
Day and Myrtle.
He missed a few drugs, but other than a few drugs he missed.
That's just like fucking... his standard day, though.
Yeah, but yeah. I was going to say, he didn't really get the heavy hitters. It was like smoke, crack, and shoot heroin. Like...
Steven, what would your standard day be?
my actual standard day, or like if I was going big?
Just go big for a day.
Yeah, if I was trying to
go big for a day. Let's hear Steven's big day.
So I would have to imagine I was on some kind of like vacation. So I would wake up and start. I'd probably drink screwdrivers.
Ooh, shit.
I could have that for breakfast.
Yeah.
Do I like a Vegas? So in Vegas, I would wake up and I have 6 or 7
South
screwdrivers.
There's from so, North Carolina.
Nah, ripped.
6 or 7 screwdrivers. Smoking weed the whole time.
What time?
11 a.m. wake up. 6 or 7 screwdrivers to 3 p.m. Maybe smoke some weed in there. I guess at 6 p.m. I would switch and like start drinking beer and whiskey pretty heavily. Then if it was a really special night, maybe do some Molly and keep drinking.
It has to be a special night.
Yeah, I mean, I have to. This has to be special for me to do this.
Why is it gonna be special?
Maybe do some blow later, just keep drinking. I would never do, like, acid after doing all that like he did. I mean, that's fucking crazy. I don't know. I would drink and do Molly and maybe do something else. Even on my craziest day, I wouldn't, like, mix that much shit. What about you guys? Or who's next? Everybody go.
Riff, what would you do?
Should we just talk about
it? Oh, should we talk about yesterday? Like, Jesus Christ. Epic day.
I wake up, go for a run.
You guys got to share
I'd
this.
I'd probably do some yoga. I'd Instagram my first meal. After I Instagram my first meal, I'd probably go back
and
do
some more yoga. And then I would insta shit after the meal.
And then, yeah, definitely
make
insta
sure
shit.
No blood.
Show them what French toast looks like in its raw form.
Deconstructed.
And then, you know, I'd probably go for a walk with the dog and, like, take a bunch of Instagram pics while I'm walking with the dog. Like, meet a couple neighbors south abroad, because that's what we do.
Yeah, we hang out. We hang out in the hood.
No, fuck that. I do a shit ton of porch drinking. I do as many drugs as can be available to the area.
Yeah?
I'd probably get on a boat, do a lot of swimming and drinking at the same time. Less drowning.
The funny part is this has never happened, though. So. Probably once.
And then, yeah. I like Molly. That'd be fun.
Here's
exactly.
My,
our fucking crazy hypothetical days don't touch his. All right, go, Paul.
So what I do is I wake up and I stand on the roof of my house. with my exposed genitals, looking at how fantastic they look in the sunlight for 30 minutes every morning.
And that's it. That's Paul's epic day.
I come inside and I cook 10 pounds of bacon. And I go walk the 15 minutes down to King and Cannon. So I'm on King Street and I throw out the bacon like I'm dropping deposits on the homeless guys.
Pay him in bacon. That's been my slogan for
you. And they eat the bacon off the ground and they're like, how do we get like you? And a jack off on it.
And no then, drugs involved.
Yeah.
I go, this is sober still. This is still sober.
Totally sober.
I eat 2 grams of Molly and 3 hits of acid.
I'm in.
And I walk down to all the corporate bank centers on Meeting and Broad Street. And I jack off on everybody who works there.
You gotta be in a business suit while you do this, too.
I walk over to the East Side Projects. And I find some young kid. And I teach him how to be a hip-hop virtuoso. And then... I walk back to Broad Street, and everybody I jacked off on, I strangled to death in front of the kid. And then
you strangle them after.
Yeah, I like
after the fact.
I like jack off on them. I go get the rap virtuoso from the hood.
Because I was gonna say, like,
Come back to Broad Street.
I was going to say...
And strangle them all in front of the rap virtuoso.
Depending on which order you do that is, like, depending on whether you get charged with assault and murder, or just murder.
I'm getting charged for assault and murder.
They're following your jizz first, at the crime scene, though.
If you do the assault after the murder,
the last thing I do is I drag all the dead bodies in 2 weeks into the storefront on King Street. And I put Merman clothes on all of them before the cops find.
You're tricky, nice. You're a tricky motherfucker.
Like, what's better advertisement than
so you? Paul's day that. Took an evil turn. Like, we were all trying to get happy and do some fucking cool drugs and get weird.
Can we talk about funny things? Like,
Paul over here just got fucking sadistic with it.
Hey. I enjoyed the story. I think we're going to, like, separate that as a whole separate, like, 3-minute clip and put that on YouTube.
Yeah.
Just Paul talking about
a day in the life of
Trump this, Hunter S.
If I can't be Hunter S. Thompson, I'm going to kill and jizz on people.
Human Landmines, sponsored by Merman Supply Company. Merman Supply Company. Get wet.
Just a couple quick news items I wanted to bring up is the Juggalos are now not only considered a gang by the FBI, but are now also considered a cult.
Oh, yes. Dude, I fucking love Juggalos. Quit hating.
So be careful.
We're not hating.
I'm not hating. We're defending them. We think they're just nice
ICFEC.
Yeah. I think Juggalos are...
Can I be honest with y'all? I went to an ICP concert once.
How was it?
It was fucking terrible.
He probably titty fucked a fat chick.
That would be the coolest thing you could do at one of those.
And they're the ones that drink Faygo, right?
They were splashing Faygo all over the stage.
Oh, God.
Griff titty fucked a fat chick at the ICP concert.
Ground Zero, Spartanburg, South Carolina.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
That's the heart of America right there. ICP concert in Spartanburg.
It was terrible.
He's the only one who's still committed to going to the ICP concert.
This was three weeks ago.
This was yesterday, motherfuckers. I'm still wiping face paint off.
Yeah. Because Butthole has so much white and black paint.
Nah, it was terrible. It was a 2-night show at this place, and CKY played the night before. Now it's definitely going to CKY.
So you're just there for that.
And then I was like, well, this school band's playing tomorrow. And I was like, yeah, I'll go. Not cool at all. I was scared.
We can have a whole Juggalo episode. as being a cult, that there's two juggalos that burned one of their other juggalos' tattoos off.
Is that why they're a cult?
No.
I think they're just a cult because they're not a...
They're a cult because they wear face paint.
They're a cult because they... And they wear baggy jeans. It's the same thing as any other gang. It's like they dress the same. They throw up juggalo... I don't even know what juggalo gangs
are. Let me be honest with everybody. If you go to a fucking building every Sunday and you pretend that you're eating the flesh of your savior and the body and blood of Christ and you have a guy in a pointy hat in Italy that you think is special, you're also in a cult. I just want to make that completely
that's
clear.
That's the reason they're cool, is they're not a recognized religion. The ICP guys are the prophets.
They were just trying to start some cool... What's the festival?
Did you just say the juggalos are the prophets?
Maybe juggalos
next
are the
question.
Real Jesus. Yeah,
next question. Stephen,
wow. I mean, juggalos is a weird breed. It's a breed we don't understand. I'm sure if we went to that whatever the festival is, the gathering of the juggalos,
we'd like to say that
we'd probably have a fucking blast.
Merman Supply Company,
and that's when we Hunter S. Thompson, because that's the opportunity to do all of those drugs in that simultaneous.
That's a great idea.
I think Hunter S. Thompson would have been a juggalo.
Stephen, can we close out on this idea?
Yeah, let's next question it.
Yeah, do we need to wrap this up? Or are we just closing that idea?
I was trying to talk about this earlier, but so a lot of people post about Robin Williams' death. Mm-hmm. And he's one of the funniest men I've ever met. And I'm pretty happy about it that I could look back and smile on his life and his whole career. But I didn't find any fucking reason to post my favorite hook clip.
Banger.
Or to post my Mrs. Doubtfire clip. Or when I did this, I did this, and somehow this makes
Toys was
this guy's death about me. Right. Why do people feel necessary to mourn on social media?
It's some shitty happens to me.
I don't fucking put it on there.
I don't know. Like, I don't even...
It's terrifying and sad.
People don't fucking put their favorite picture, fucking clip of their grandma dancing when their grandma dies. Like,
that's,
I don't know.
The exact point. Nigel said it best. Like, Robin Williams cannot read your Facebook tweet in fucking heaven.
Like I said over and over, I want to know what you had for lunch and what you and your mom are up to on a casual Sunday.
I think as a social media protest, we should all start taking pictures of our shits after we eat really good food, but like just captioning it with the good food, like French toast and poached egg over arugula, but it's just a picture
to
of
die
a
for.
To die for.
No, you know what? I'm going to start posting pictures of my shits and then put inspirational quotes over them. In big, bold, white lettering.
Believe in yourself.
It's going to be a picture of my shit and be like, hashtag, she left you because she's not right. But...
Hashtag how do plants grow. Hashtag fertilizer. I'm taking dumps in gardens, bitch.
Hey,
no, I picture my shit. I have Steven's back on this. Like, we need to do... We need to post stupid shit.
But that's like one of my other pet peeves, though. It's like, think about like
all
the pictures
time.
Of like a sunset.
We need
have...
to be a product of it.
We're just a generation of people trying to understand how to accept the internet.
What about a picture of your
shit? We'll figure it out.
What about a picture of his shit and it says, God gives you only what you can handle. And I just gave this toilet hell.
Faith is not knowing what the future holds, but knowing who holds the future.
And just a fucking doogie pile.
Who holds the future?
Hashtag.
Bill Gates? The director.
Did just fall down?
Oh, it's getting weird over in the Tokyo.
The future of humanity?
Yes, as a final thought, Paul. Were you trying to segue me, Paul?
I was segueing you into the future holder of humanity. What's his name?
I'm gonna pull it up now.
Yeah, so can we all pull this up? Because Paul just told me about this, but I gotta see this.
This is a happier thing and a hilarious. Oh, his name's Nick Bostrom, and he looks hilarious. But his official title is the director of the future of humanity, and it's his job to make sure robots don't take over the earth. So all of our faith.
What does he do on a daily Nick basis? Bostrom.
Let's check his Facebook. I'm sure he's got yoga poses and French toast.
He's on the boat.
He brings up a pretty crazy thing, Paul. Like, I always thought, like, when robots were going to kill us all, it would be, like, war robots. But he talks about, like, even if there's a robot in a paperclip factory, and their algorithm says, make paperclips as efficiently as possible. And so they're just trying to do that. If they figure out that killing every human on Earth will make paperclips more efficiently, they might just kill everyone. It doesn't even have to be a war robot. It could be any robot.
Those paperclips are shifty little fuckers, so...
Exactly.
I've always firmly believed in staples.
Yeah, you hate paperclips?
Yeah, I hate them. I'm a staple guy through and through.
Yeah, paperclips aren't stable. They don't...
Well, imagine this staple robot killing everybody.
But they're not.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, I was trying to make that a positive story, and now we got to robots killing everybody.
Now we're just fucking hating on paperclips.
The positive part of it is that there's a guy looking out for us who's going to make sure robots don't kill everyone.
What's his name?
Nick Bostrom. He's a middle-aged Anglo gentleman with a polka dot coffee cup.
Yeah. He's literally...
He's wearing a cardigan.
What's his title, Stephen?
I don't know, director of the future of humanity or something.
Hell, director of the future of humanity.
You gotta hold that title fucking strong.
What a boss. I bet he gets
this
laid.
This guy literally
spends
all
so.
His
the
days hoping
the
that the fucking robots.
Maybe lacing ropes out, making people.
Nah, he'll be fucking robots by next week.
So. What I've learned today is that either the Insane Clown Posse or Nick Bostrom are the real Jesus, and we should all put our faith in either the Juggalos or him, and otherwise we will surely perish in a filthy fucking sewer of gangs, cults, and robots. And those are my closing thoughts.
It wouldn't surprise me if an apocalyptic thing happened and the Juggalos survived.
It kind of looks
longer
like
longer than most.
They're like the roaches.
Because meth will take you like 4 days, zombie mode.
Shit. Do we all need to become Juggalos?
Well, I think we just need to start fucking doing meth.
All right. I'm down.
Final thoughts. Let's do meth.
Paul, can you send me meth next time instead of a t-shirt?
Yeah, nah, you need to wear that t-shirt every day. Steven, I'm
that
serious.
That shirt's
if
made out of meth. Chew on it.
Merman meth. The best quality.
What if we
for your dollar.
Infusing meth with our ink so you can just chew on your shirt when you need to
Oh, you guys are giving away the new business plan.
No, we already gave away all the new business plans. Our applications are all over the internet now.
Insta-meth.
They just started.
Abortstagram.
Steven. Paul, do you have any closing thoughts?
Last night, I told a man and woman playing Big Bug Hunter so far that big game hunting made me sick. And I couldn't imagine how they could find their fun. But they did find a father, and they said it was just a video game. And I said, if there was an abortion video game, would you have fun playing that too? You big bunch of sinners and hellions and the people destined for damnation!
Dude, can we end with that Paula Deen shit?
Yay.
Can we play that, Steven?
Hey.
The slowed down video of Paula Deen and Oprah?
We're never gonna play it, Steven. Don't.
We're never gonna play it.
Grist it, man.
Hey, everybody, thanks for listening. Buy Merman Supply Company apparel. They're all about getting it wet or whatever.
Merman Supply Company. Merman Supply Company. Get wet.
Steven, it's thanks been for being fun on the talking show, shit Nigel with you. Griff. Always yeah. a fucking pleasure. Show, gentlemen. Love you guys.
You guys are fucking awesome.
To the Tokyo yeah, Studios. Dude,
until next time. We should do cheers, this more bitches. Often.
Cheers, bitches. When I was 21.